Right, here we are. It's Christmas time. So let's have a Christmas carol. Good old traditional, Away in a Manger, which was written, well, sometime in the last century, or maybe even the one before that. Now what's going to happen is I'm going to go through the main style. I'll then explain what I'm doing. The tab will appear, and then after the tab's been up for a few seconds, it'll disappear, and we'll talk about how we can make the basic song a little more interesting. Right, so here we go, Away in a Manger, and I'm going to use a plectrum. I know I'm sitting with a classical guitar, but shock horror, I'm going to use a plectrum just to prove that you can do this on your seven string dobro flying V or whatever you happen to have. Now the secret to this particular style, two things. You have to have good breaks, you have to know just how much of each chord to play. You don't necessarily want to strum across to the first string, because if the melody note happens to lie on the second string, well, that's where you want to stop. The human ear will zoom into the highest note that it hears, so you always want the melody note to be the last one you play as you're strumming across your chord, whether it's on the third string or the second string, or obviously on the first. Second thing you've got to watch for are there any notes that need to be added into the chord, notes that don't normally live there, and we'll come across an example of that as we go through the song. So first of all, it's third string open, and then a chord, a C chord, conventional C, but I'm going from the fifth string, stopping on the second, like so, not because that effectively alters the tune. Now here's an example of the second thing I was talking about there, where you have to add a note into the chord. My pinky is now sitting on the first string, third fret. I haven't moved anything else, it was just the pinky that I had to move. Now here's my next chord, and it's a D minor seventh, and the way I'm playing it, my first finger has flattened 21 and 11, second string first fret and first string first fret. My next finger comes across and grabs third string second fret there, and I play it from the fourth, like so. You can, if you find that awkward, you can use three fingers, so first finger on the second string, second finger on the first string, third finger on the third string. Comes to the same thing. Sounds exactly the same, but you may find it more comfortable. Our next chord is a G7th. That's that. Now how to think of it is, it's like a C chord, but you've expanded it. The first finger moves across, leaves the second string, ends up on the first string. And these two pop across onto the fifth and sixth, and that's a G7th. Conventional C chord all the way across. That was a bit of a D. I'm just going from the fourth to the second my melody notes come in. And I play a G chord, stopping on the second string. The next bit of the song is pretty much a repeat until we get to the last two bars. Now in those last two bars, there was a D minor came in there. We didn't actually need the first string, but I put my finger on it anyway, just in case I overshoot. I know I'm busy telling you I don't want to hear a note higher than the melody, but it's better to have rather than that, a bit of a discord. So it's a precaution. Plus, I think just mentally, you're not having to learn new chord shapes. If you just put in the shape you're familiar with, whether you're going to use all the notes, yeah, that's beside the point. But it saves you learning a whole load of new shapes. There was a G chord again to the second string, and a C chord stopping on the second. Like so. Right, the tab will now appear. Pause the video, because it's only going to be there for a few seconds. Pause the video and have a go yourself. And then we'll talk about slightly different styles that we can use. Now, that was with a plectrum. Let's discard the plectrum. And I'm going to use the instrumental style that I use. Now, I normally only use two fingers and my thumb. It's like a wee gun. I only use two fingers and a thumb. Now, when it's just a single note, you can use whatever finger you like to pluck it. Doesn't matter. But when you come to a chord, what I want you to do is, because your middle finger in most normal human beings is the longest finger, as you turn your hand down towards the guitar, it's the middle one that's going to play the melody note at the chord. And your neighbouring index finger acts as if it's actually glued to your first finger, and it's going to play whatever string happens to be it's the neighbour to the melody note. And as long as you're actually holding the chord shape, you're going to get a harmony, guaranteed. What your thumb is doing is it's plucking the bass note for the chord. Now, as a rough guide to where your bass notes will be, if, for example, A, G, it's E or G, then it's going to be on the sixth string. Also works for E minor. They're all on the sixth string. A, B or C, you're on the fifth. And anything that's left over, which in practical terms is D and F, they start from the fourth. Although it wouldn't be deadly if you happen to hit the fifth string on that. Right, so let's hear what it sounds like now, played two fingers and a thumb. Two fingers and a thumb. Now you'll notice in one of the chords there, I actually strummed across, and you can mix the two styles. Like so. So you're not confined to one or the other. Or you could decide, that the first verse you'll use the strummed kind of plectrum style if you like, even though you are using just your fingers. Second verse, you might do the two fingers and thumb. Third verse, you might do a mix of the two. It's one of the problems that instrumentalists have, is how to keep it interesting after the second time. Come that third time, how do you make it interesting for the listener? If you're singing, well then there's a story unfolding and the story keeps the listener's attention. But if you're not singing, it's very easy to lose the audience and they start chatting amongst themselves. Depending on the situation, that's fine. If you're in a restaurant, well, that's what you expect. But if you're at a concert, how do you actually keep their attention? And the way to do it is to try and vary what you're doing as you're going along. So there you go, Away in a Manger. Last thing, Merry Christmas.